After 12 recent rounds of negotiations and decades of tension between Japan and South Korea, a deal is finally reached to resolve the conflict over comfort women, many of them Korean women who were forced to serve as sex slaves in Japanese military brothels in the years leading up to and during World War II. If the Japanese government carries out its end of the deal by putting up around $8 million for a foundation to support the surviving women, South Korea will consider the matter irreversibly resolved.
In order to restore dignity and regain the impaired reputation of the comfort women, as well as heal their wounded hearts through the agreement, I think it is most important that the Japanese government swiftly and faithfully carry out the measures under the deal.
I think we did our duty for the current generation by reaching this final and irreversible resolution before the end of the 70th year since the war.
The announcement of the deal comes with a message that Japan's Prime Minister Shinzo Abe again expresses his most sincere apologies and remorse to all the women who suffered. It also has the government taking responsibility for the military's use of comfort women. But one group representing survivors says the apology is too vague and it fails to make explicitly clear the Japanese government's role in perpetuating the crimes against women. Kim Bok-dung is one of those women forced to leave her Korean village at the age of 14. She says she was used for 5 years as a sex slave.
I can't put into words the scars it left me with. It still keeps me awake at night. It went on for such a long time. By the time the sun went down, I couldn't use my lower body at all. In my old age, I couldn't have a single person who can call me mother. I couldn't never have a child.
Kim is one of 46 living survivors. There are estimates that some 200,000 women were used by the Japanese military as comfort women. In Seoul, Alexandra Field, CNN.